I think I'll just relax a bit and just go with the flow. If you feel like laughing, laugh. If you feel like crying, cry. All right. One day, I was asked to write a love poem. But for some reason, I wrote a poem about why I couldn't write a love poem. Well, today, I'm not going to write a poem about why I can't write a love poem because I've decided to repent of my decision not to write a love poem. Don't get me wrong, I still haven't written that love poem, but I'm here to tell you that one day I'm going to write a love poem. One day I'm going to write a love poem about how you laid your descending eyes on me and chased me faster than Tom chased Jerry. No, I didn't steal your boss's cheese, it was because you knew you had met the one who will make your heart merry, with whom when you add yourself to will still remain one. And no mountain high enough could keep you away from me. They were like Everest to Mallory, hopelessly dunking yourself into valleys like my grandma does with agege bread when she finds a giant cup of tea. And the planes were just the consolation prize you gained just to reach me. And eventually, the love between you and I became a reflection of the perfect love between the church and Christ. One day, I'm going to write a love poem about how I finally gave you a chance. And then my only regret was that I had not given you that chance much earlier. Because no matter how many times I've been frustrated, hurt, disappointed, rejected, I'm pushed into believing that all men are cheats, bad liars, dogs, and all those appalling words used by ladies looking for a defense mechanism to shield themselves from hurt. Because I know you were good, you were kind, you were loving, you will pray for me and protect me. You will cover me spiritually, physically, and financially. Or how else am I supposed to one day write a love poem for you if you do not possess all these fine qualities? One day, I'm going to write a love poem about how the attraction between us is so strong, and then I want to kiss you as you want to kiss me, hold you as you want to hold me, get lost in your arms. I'm like, no, 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 no! I can't do this, I'm a Christian! And they'll pour cold water on heads and chew ice cubes just to douse the passion of the moment, the fire on our tongues and the heat on our body, and cry about why we can't speedily get married. One day, I'm going to write a love poem about how I had been praying for you, constantly reminding God about the specs I want in you, conveniently forgetting that God never forgets or needs to memorize since he is memory all by himself, the one who created time immemorial. Not asking for the usual tall, dark, handsome, rich girls, rich dudes girls always pray for nowadays, because I mean, those are the only kind of guys that walk up to me anyway. But how I want a man that will not beat me. God. I said, I want a man that will not beat me. God, in case you did not hear, I said, I want a man that will not beat me. Because you see, my father never turned my mother into a daily punching bag, so I see no reason why I should be the one to introduce that appalling trend into my family. So I'm performing this piece now. Just in case you were thinking of walking up to me, and you are the kind of guy that cannot keep your fist to yourself, you will not even bother smelling the fragrance of my direction, because now you know it's definitely not you I'm performing this piece for. One day, I'm going to write a love poem about how, on our wedding night, I sat you down and gave you a 1-hour lecture of how I kept my body for you, even though it was very difficult, but I still did. And how I maintain the size 6 for you, and therefore deserve my own bride price. Not the tubers of yams, the bunches of plantain, and the 10 naira you paid my Yoruba parents, but my own bride price. So yes, you will have to pay. Not for my body, since it's already yours anyway, but for the fact that you wasted my time and kept me waiting for unnecessarily long, even longer than my mom's lentil pancakes and kobokos. But yes, maybe not unnecessarily, since the waiting made me stronger, wiser, better, more prepared, and a seasoned spoken word artist who is now standing here presenting a poem about how one day I'll write a love poem for you. But anyway, you will still pay, and it will be per second billing for every year you made me wait. So yes, do the math, because there's no escaping it. Well, since you'll be a billionaire, it won't be a big deal. Wait. I did not add billionaire to the specs when I was praying for a man that would not beat me. Oh, man. She wasted prayer points. One day, I'm going to write a love poem about how at this very moment I stood here and said, one day I'm going to write a love poem, and that poem beckoned on you as you couldn't resist the drag, the pull tugging at your heart, threatening to tear you apart, and then you couldn't resist the force. It was like when the North Pole traveled to meet South, because you knew without a doubt it was you I was talking to, and you couldn't stay away again, even though you had been fighting, resisting the pressure of the familiar forces that had been pulling you away from me, because at this very moment, listening to me, you knew you just had to have me, because living your life without me will make your life as purposeless, as bland as an oatmeal. If you are wise, you will know it's you I'm talking to. One day, I'm going to write a love poem about you, for you, to you, but sadly, that day is not today. Thank you. Thank you.